In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John, chapters 13, verse 21 through 33, and verse 36 to 38. After saying this, Jesus was troubled in spirit and declared, "Very truly I tell you, one of you will betray me." The disciples looked at one another, uncertain of whom he was speaking. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining next to him. Simon Peter therefore motioned to him to ask Jesus of whom he was speaking. So while reclining next to Jesus, he asked him, "Lord, who is it?" Jesus answered, "It is the one to whom I give this piece of bread when I have dipped it in the dish." So when he had dipped the piece of bread, he gave it to Judas, son of Simon Iscariot. After he received the piece of bread, Satan entered into him. Jesus said to him, "Do quickly what you are going to do." Now, no one at the table knew why he said this to him. Some thought that because Judas had the common purse, Jesus was telling him, "Buy what we need for the festival," or that he should give something to the poor. So after receiving the piece of bread, he immediately went out, and it was night. When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, where are you going?" Jesus answered, "Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, but you will follow afterward." Peter said to him, "Lord, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you." Jesus answered, "Will you lay down your life for me? Very truly, I tell you, before the cock crows, you will have denied me three times." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Sisters and brothers, on this day, Tuesday of the Holy Week, our team reflects on, "Lay down your life for me." It is not for nothing that this week is called holy. This week is like the period of the Father, where the Father of the house is facing a sure that. He gathers his children and begins to tell them important things. It is a very solemn period. Even the wayward children do comport themselves during this time. Only Jesus knew for sure how serious it was. People like Peter and the rest of the disciples did not understand. Jesus was troubled in the spirit, something unusual in his life. One of his own disciples was already planning to betray him, and all the warnings could not change his hardened and treacherous heart. In order to make Jesus feel better, Peter made a promise without knowing the implications. "I would lay down my life for you," Peter said. Laying down life is not a child's play. It is not something you wake up and run into. And that is why it is important to know our level of commitment to God. What makes it difficult in the case of Jesus was that he has the power to say no. It was a complete free will donation. His life was not taken away from him. He laid it down. This is why he is both the priest and the victim, both on the cross and on the altar. Even the martyrs lay down their lives not for Christ, but for the sake of Christ. They didn't die to save Jesus. Jesus died rather to save them. May we prepare ourselves to adore and appreciate the one who laid down his life for us, the one who gave it all. And may we learn to lay down whatever we can for the sake of others through Christ. Let us at this point continue to seek the face of Jesus, even as we prepare towards the culmination of Jesus' death on the cross. As we continue to ask for His divine presence and grace, we believe that our commitment as Christians to God will continue to be a source of blessing to our entire world for redemption and for freedom through Christ our Lord. Righteous Father, we thank You for who You are and for all that You've been for us and with us. Give us, O Lord, a steadfast heart which no unworthy thoughts can drag downwards, an unconquered heart which no tribulation can wear out, an upright heart which no unworthy purpose may tempt aside. Bestow upon us also, O God, an understanding to know You, diligence to seek You, wisdom to find You, and a faithfulness that may finally embrace You through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like You. All of my days I want to praise the wonders of